I'm gonna link it down below because for the sake of time. So I'm gonna go straight into my transition for my eyes, and of course I'm gonna be using Espresso from the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit in the shade medium to tan. And I'm gonna use this brush to start building my transition into the crease. Remember, not being too precise. Today I'm going to go on to my Tarte in the Bloom palette, take the shade Sweetheart, and just start building my crease. They have a lot of fallout, but as long as it's pigmented, I don't think I really care. So just pop this in the crease. Next, I'm gonna go into the shade Rebel, which is, well, I'm not gonna show you guys because I don't want it falling out. It's such a pretty color. But yeah, I'm gonna take the shade Rebel and I'm just gonna work this into the crease also. I do use the same blending brush because why not? It works for me. So just focus this on the outer V. Now we're just going to add the shade Rebel into the crease once again. Make sure everything is nice and blended. I like how this eye came along in this eye, but it's not bad. So we'll try to see if we can go into the color that's broken. It's called Funny Girl. I'm just gonna take this one that came with my Urban Decay Naked 3 palette, I think. Yeah, and this is not a good blending brush. It's a really good eyeshadow brush. Go into the shade Funny Girl and then pop this all over the lid. Just going to blend and make sure there's no harsh edges. If you have a glitter glue, I recommend putting that down before you put any glitter down. I have one, I just forgot to use it. So I'm gonna go in with mascara now. I'm gonna go on Maybelline, the Colossal Spider Effect mascara, and just coat my lashes with that. Okay, now that we're satisfied with that, I'm gonna go into foundation. I'm gonna use my CoverGirl Clean Matte BB Cream, and this is for oily skin. It's supposed to keep you matte all day, which I think it does a good job of doing. So I'm going to put that on the back of my hand, and I'm going to go in with a new clean, well it's not new, but I washed it, Real Techniques Complexion Sponge, and just put that all over my face. I'm buffing out. Oh yeah, I already primed also, so. Oh yeah, how do you guys feel about me doing like a clothing haul? Like, I really, really want to do one. Comment down below if you guys would like to see one. Tarte Shape Tape. I have dark circles. I know you guys may not see it, but like I'm dark skin also, but I do have dark circles under my eyes, and this just helps to conceal and brighten them, which is something I really look for in a concealer. Also to cover up any blemishes that I couldn't get covered by my foundation. So I'm just gonna go back in with my sponge and just blend that out. Face looks so dewy, I love it. Next, I'm gonna bake with my RCMA powder. I wasn't sure what lip color I was gonna do, but now I'm sure. And that'll be like the main focus of this look. So I'm not really gonna do a lot of bronzing today. I'm just gonna do a light thingy. I'm gonna go into the NYX Cheek Contour Dual Palette. You guys have seen this so many times on my channel. I'm just in the shade Wine and Dine, as usual. And I'm just gonna bronze up the skin a bit. Satisfied with how that turned out. So now we're just going to dust off the baking that's happening on our face. Hold me close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. And I'm just going to go into a highlighting powder just to highlight points of my face that the light naturally hits. So I'm gonna go into my Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit in the shade Macchiato right there, and not just, not Macchiato, I'm gonna go into Peaches and Cream, which is that one over here, and it's very, very, very highlighting. And then just go under my eyes, on my chin, under my contour, and just highlight it. Bridge my nose also. So for highlight, I'm gonna go on to Laura Geller Baked Gelato Illuminator, which looks like this. And I'm going to put that on the bridge of my nose, on the tops of my cheekbones, on my cupid's bow, just highlight my life away. This be. Lipstick, I'm gonna go in with ColourPop Ultra Matte Lip in the shade Limbo. This is like a nice brownie mixed with like a little bit of red-ish. I'm not gonna say it's brick red, but it's like definitely more on the brownie side. And I love this color, especially in the fall when I want a dark lip to wear. This is just perfect, perfect, perfect. So I'm gonna just apply that on my lips. Turn us to thousands. Formula lipsticks are one of my favorite of all time, hands down. And yeah, this just looks like a very deep chocolate color, which I love. I'm just gonna wait for that to dry, which won't take a very long time. I can already feel it. Let's try it. For the last step, you guys all know what I'm about to do with this thing. I'm gonna just merge all the powders to my skin with my Mario Badescu rose water. Just let that dry. So this is the completed look. Thank you all for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video as much as I did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!